going on, guys? This is Nick, and today's gig log, we're DJing our final homecoming of the season. This is going to be Queensbury's homecoming, and I'm very excited about this because we're bringing a fuck ton of gear, and especially in the lighting department, the most I have ever brought into a gig. Let me show you guys. So right now we're charging everything up, and I know somebody's going to comment like, oh, you shouldn't charge Chinese lights unattended because you know your house can go. Anyways, guys, we are rocking not one, not two, but 13 of these older generic battery-powered LED lights. You've seen these probably in some other gig logs. And then we're rocking another 16 brand new both lighting S6s that you saw in the previous skip log, which was a wedding. Also charging some wireless transmitters, kind of using my old SX case, which the SX is currently sitting upstairs on my desk for practicing. To store the charge because it's got a power strip where you can set all the donors and they can just sit in there. We also have not one but three T-bars with four lights, and yes, I know trussing would have been better, but I ain't got that type of money. But the real reason is I do have the money, but it's for 4 gigs at a year, or maybe even 8 if you count prom season. Yeah, look at all this charger thing. We're charging a lot of stuff. Sadly, these don't have the power cons like the full-size S6s do. Anyways, guys, see you in the gig. And for those of you wondering what I use to transport my SoundSwitch and actually my lighting receivers around, it's just this, I think it's like a tool case. I found it. But it's got these like dividers, so I carry my old MyDMX, even though I'm never going to use this thing again. Hit me up if you want to buy it. Maybe I'll give you guys a good price. I basically took the box for the sound switch, like took the foam out of it, and then I strapped it down. So, I mean, that's not going anywhere, and if not, it's protected very well. That's where I put all my charges. I currently have those two, and then I just sort of put all 14 of my donors in this slot. And actually, so I used to use the donors because some of these guys didn't, like, work at the wireless, but I found out that the entire time it's because some of these were set to master. So they kept trying to transmit signals, and it kind of screwed with some of them, so. Pro tip, set them all to slave if you got lights that are like this, that have the confusing menu system. I bought them secondhand, so I didn't know.
So we were at Queensbury High School, and I mean, it's almost time. We're, like, 10 to 15 till doors, and Queensbury says, hey, Nick, I want an insane over-the-top light show. Let me show you what we're working with today. Up lights for days. It's like the most amount of gear I brought in, which is kind of sad because it's not that much. So this is, we're rocking three T-bars. One has four meg bar and the stands, of course. The other, I'm mirroring it on side. And then this side has just the pars. We're rocking 16 both lighting S6s, S6 minis to be precise. And then the back ones are just other generic Chinese uplights. Got a ton. And then let's, sounds usual, ZLX on each side with the ETX in the middle. ETX subs, of course, mixer rack below the table. Should probably hide this gaff tape. ASUS for backup and Lenovo for remain. And of course the SX2. And we got SoundSwitch fully working today. You should see the light show set. Got a GoPro recording up there. One thing I learned is attaching a battery pack to the top. So yeah, see you guys soon.
Oh, Thank you.